Okay, hello everybody, and I hope you're getting sound with this. And we're going to just try and be able to see my screen. So here's Tinkercad, and your next assignment is to draw something that looks like breakfast. So I just wanted to go over a few tricks that you can use to do this. So let me just click on the milk, or whatever that is, and let's just hide that for a second. So one of the things that's kind of hard to do is to create the spoon, the bowl, and then of course the mug. So let's just make a new Tinkercad here and let's recreate a few of these things. Every time you open up Tinkercad, it auto-generates the name, which is kind of weird, but let's just call it Breakfast Test. Lesson. Okay, so the first thing is let's make the mug. So when I drew the mug, the first thing I did was I found the cone and dragged the cone out and dropped it on. And then I switched to the top view. And let's just make that a little bigger. And then I took a box and I actually put a box right on top of it. And then let's switch to the front view. And then let's pull the box up. Move away for a sec. Let's make the cone a little taller. And then let's drop the box back down again. Drop it down a little bit more. And then, of course, I'm going to make the box a hole. I'm going to select all of it, and I use Command A or Control A on a PC, and then cut the top off the cone. So that's actually called a truncated cone. The next thing I want to do with the truncated cone is rotate it. And remember that when I go to rotate, if I put my hand inside on the rotation handle, it moves in increments of 22.5 degrees, which gives us a really nice rotation. And now I'm going to take that same cone and I'm going to duplicate it. And then I'm going to pull it upwards. Go to the top view. And then I'm actually going to hold down Shift and make it slightly smaller. Then I'm going to recenter it in the object. And then I'm going to turn it into a hole. Again, select everything. Control A, Command A, Mac. And then I'm going to use the group command to cut it out. So there's my hollow cup. And now I'm going to create a handle. And to use the handle, you have this kind of a weird shape called a rounded roof. And I'm going to drag that in. And then I'm going to go to the top view again. And you'll notice I switch views a lot. Let's get rid of our whole cup here for a second. Let's just hide that. And let's take that. We're going to make a handle. So I'm going to make that a little bit smaller. And then I'm going to copy it. And the one that I copy, I'm going to make it bigger. So then let's switch to the front view. And then I'm going to resize, hopefully, the one that's inside. Didn't do a very good job lining that up, did I? That looks better. Okay, so now I'm going to make that a hole. Again, I'm going to select everything, group those two, and there's my handle. I click on the light bulb to have the glass shown again, and now I'm going to rotate my glass. Let's go to top view and line that up. Move all the way to the top. Obviously, I want that in the middle. And move front. And let's look at the top to make sure that the handle isn't actually sticking through my... Okay, let's select all of it, and this time we'll group them together. Wait, let's ungroup that first. Let's duplicate this, just the cup for a second. Just pull that out of the way. Now let's take those two things, shift-click, and group them together. And then let's hide that. Okay, so here's my... There's my new cup, and this time I'm going to take it and I'm going to make a plate out of it. Now notice that I can make an oblong plate. If I hold down shift, it makes the object stay, in this case, round. Let's go to the front view, and then let's make it kind of flat. There's my plate. And let's hide that again. Let's select everything and hide it. Okay, so now let's try to make the bowl. So in this case, there's a half sphere, so I took the half sphere for the bowl. And then I, again, Okay, so I got a little crash action here happening. So usually what I would do with the half sphere is drop it on and it just keeps disappearing. Okay, so I'm going to just reload this page. So let's try drawing the bowl again. So I'm going to start off with the half sphere. Oh, it's going to keep disappearing on me. Okay, that's going to blow up my lesson. I'm going to stop here for now, and I'll try and reload the software. Actually, let's just reload it totally. Third time's lucky, I hope. So, let's find the half sphere. Yay! Okay. So, we're going to do exactly the same thing. We're going to go to the top view. We're going to place a bowl and place a box on top of it. Go to the front view. We're going to lift that up. We're going to have a flat bottom, make it a hole, select everything, cut it off. We're going to turn our bowl, turn it over. We're going to duplicate it. I'm going to lift one copy up, go to the top view, resize the top one a little bit. Make it a hole, select it all, cut it out. So there's our bowl. Now, the cool thing is about the bowl is I use that to make the spoon. So I just made a copy of my bowl. Let's hide our bowl for a second. And let's go to top view. So obviously the bowl part of the spoon is oblong and shorter. Now, here's a cool tool that I thought was really cool that I hadn't really seen before, this scribble tool. So let's grab a scribble, put it in. It comes up with a new drawing surface. And if you draw kind of the arc of a spoon handle, and then say you're done, it brings in this shape, which you can then squash down and play with that a little bit. And then I just rotated it. If it wants to rotate today. And now let's go to the top view again. Let's make my handle a little narrower. Let's make it bigger. So you can see both of them. Okay, so my scale of my handle is still off a little bit. Let's make that a little longer. I think I need to rotate it. It's going the wrong way, isn't it? Okay, let's go to the front side. Handle so it intersects the cup of the spoon, and then select both of them and then group them together. And that's how I made the spoon. So that's kind of it. I hope this helps, and I apologize for the few glitches, but let's try this out and see where you get. So your next step is going to be to draw a breakfast and then a quick keychain. I'm going to do a quick one on the keychain and we'll let you play with making some toys. Good luck, guys.